Welcome, fans. Thanks for joining us for this Friday night edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan, joined by the talented analyst tandem of Greg Anthony and Chris Webber. David Aldridge is on our sideline. DA, take it away.
De'Aaron Fox talked about his mentality on the court. You put the ball in his hands, he says, I'm going to take over the game. It doesn't have to be scoring, just always attacking. Always. You gotta be a dog. Don't back down from anyone. Kevin, I know you're a dog. Back to you.
A little intimidation factor, DA. Thanks. We've got a quick moment now to take a look at the long-term rebounding numbers over several seasons for Adebayo.
He's really made that a focus of his game these past few years, and it's paid big-time dividends for him. He's become a much better rebounder, and it's increased his value as a player by leaps and bounds.
So here's Miami's starting group. They've got Adebayo. Robinson is out there with Myers Leonard. Then there's Jimmy Butler. And it's Nunn in at the point guard. And for the Kings, Fox at the point with Heald to his side. They're the backcourt. Giles is out there with Bialica. And it's Barnes in at the small forward. There should be plenty of fireworks out in the backcourt tonight in this one. Of the guards you played alongside, who is the best combination passer score?
Oh, man, Kev, you put me on the hot seat. That's a tough one. I just got to give everybody
a shout out. You played with a lot
of
them, though, didn't you?
I know, man. I didn't know it was going to be a test today. I got to go with my boy Rod Strickland when I played with him at the Wizards. I think he's the best finisher ever, and he led the league in assists. My boy Jay Will, shout out to White Chocolate. He is one of the most creative players I've ever played with, but he can shoot it from deep. He was a guy that liked to shoot it from Curry Land, and he could pass it. And then lastly, I'd have to, of course, go with my man Mike Bibby. Mike Bibby could do it all. So I've been blessed to play and fortunate to play with some great scorers and combination passers in this league.
Three terrific names. And so it's the Kings getting on the board first. Just five on the clock. Here's Butler. Hits some rim on the way in, and the bucket's good.
Some say the mid-range jumper is dying out. Yeah, right. Guys like Butler, they're keeping it alive.
Now, here's Fox. He's guarded closely, and it's blocked. And Robinson wide open. He shoots. Gets a very good look and converts. And here's Fox. He'll bring it up for Sacramento. Now the pass to Barnes. First 1:30 gone here in the first quarter. On the wing, Heald. It's rebounded by Leonard.
He makes a lot more of those than he misses. Not sure what threw him off right there.
Butler passes to Nunn. Back to Butler. Shot clock at 6. That one's not going to go. And Sacramento will go the other way with it. The Heat beat them last time when these two teams met down in South Florida.
And their last time playing this club, foul trouble became a big problem for them. Their starters had to take an early stint on the bench.
Yeah, and they can't afford a repeat of that. They need a lot more minutes out of their core group tonight.
Here's Nunn. He's coming off a 13-point game against the Clippers. Outside Butler. Unloads from 13. That one a little long. And here's Heald. He'll bring it up for the Sacramento Kings. Trailing by 2. Bialica passes to Fox. Dishes it to Heald. And once again off the mark by Sacramento.
Just 1 for 5 from the field now. I mean, they've come out flat. They need to pick up the energy.
It's deflected, and they'll keep possession.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
Now with this face-up game, Myers Leonard comfortable playing at power forward or center.
Yeah, Kevin, but if you look at the muscle he's added, he sure looks like a pivot. I mean, 7 foot
take a break.
One,
take a break.
Solid, 260. The hammer. Well, that's at least what he calls himself. He's ready to bang.
That free throw good from Leonard. And the former number 11 pick in 2012, it's taken some time for Myers Leonard. But you know what, Chris? The last couple of seasons, his offensive game really is rounding into form.
Yeah, and I wonder, because he's a great shooter and a quick twitch athlete that can get his head at the rim, with the strong season at the line, could he be inducted into the 50, 40, 90 club?
Chris, when Bielitsa is on the floor, he certainly gives this offense a different look.
Yeah, Bielitsa does a fantastic job spreading the floor and opening the lanes for the rest of the team. He doesn't have to play 30 minutes to make his impact felt out there on the floor. Just key stretches to free things up.
Here's Nunn. Sacramento able to drain the three. Here's Butler. Offensive rebound. Adebayo. And Adebayo throws it down.
And just scrapes and claws for that offensive rebound and doesn't take any chances there with the putback.
NGA strong work all around. And the rebound and the stuff both. Wow. Now, here's Fox. Coming off a solid outing against Minnesota. That's in. He's got two made now, and he's shooting two for three.
Well, to deal with the bigger defenders in the NBA, Fox had to learn the floater. I mean, as you can see, he learned it pretty well.
Here's Nunn, guarded by Fox. Deep two from Robinson. The rebound by Giles. Sacramento's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. And it's sent back by Leonard. Here's Butler. And slam dunk by Butler.
Well, that's just who Butler is. An opportunistic scorer who pounces on any available lane he sees.
Fox passes to Giles. Pass to Barnes. Oh, and the dunk by Barnes.
And guys, that's not as easy as he made it look. You've got to have some skills to pull that off.
Well, he's got plenty of those, yes. That's for sure. Here's Nunn. He's still scoreless so far in this one. And it's Bielitsa with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. And some changes here for the Heat. Crowder, he's checked in for Myers Leonard. And it's Iguodala in for Robinson. On defense, the Kings. Offensive rebound. Here's Adebayo. And another shot. That one's a miss. His third shot of the game. He's made one of them.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
But he stays with it.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
Here's Iguodala. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Giles has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Healed, can't hit. On offense, here are the Heat. A three ball. The rebound by Giles. Giles has got his fifth rebound in this one. Barnes outside. There's the dish to Fox. Down low. And Bielitsa kicks to Healed. On the clock. The Kings need to get off a shot here. Bielitsa misses.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
Well, that's why he's out there right now. In situations like this, he stands tall to prevent points.
Now here's Iguodala. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Back to Adebayo. Over Bielitsa. Miami no good on that time either.
Oh, he found the open space for mid-range. Just maybe rushed his release a little bit.
And stolen by Butler. And Iguodala with a clear path to the hoop. And Andre Iguodala with the slam.
Well, he's known for his defensive chops. Butler, he is opportunistic and aggressive in how he comes up with steals.
So the Kings call timeout. They're first. They're coming off that win against Minnesota.
Well, it's easy to score when you're facing very little resistance. That's why their offense looks so good in that one.
Yeah, but you also got to give credit to the offense, too. I mean, they exploited every hole they saw in the defense.
A big group substitution here for Sacramento. Alex Lenz checked in for Bielitsa. Bogdan Bogdanovich comes in for Barnes. Kent Bazemore's checked in for Buddy Hield. And Corey Joseph subbed in for Fox. Now, here's Joseph. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. Again, the miss by the Kings.
And Kevin, they need to be consistent with their effort on the boards. You look at the box score, and they're at a definite disadvantage.
And out of Marquette, Jake Crowder, a sturdy two-way wing player.
A great system player and glue guy. He had his best years with the Celtics. On the final year of this contract, a great value considering what he brings to the
shooting
table.
Two.
And that one misses.
Well, one thing the Kings have on their roster are very active bigs.
Yeah, guys like Bagley, Giles, and so on. I mean, they all move great, G.A. I mean, these guys help the Kings to thrive in transition. They got quick big men that can also start the break by bringing it up themselves.
Good on the second free throw. Now, there's the talk about lowering the minimum draft age from 19 back to 18. And, Chris, how much of a difference does that 1 year make in a player's maturity?
It makes so much difference. I mean, you're young. You're coming into a league. You're playing against grown men. Just physically, your body hasn't been able to catch up. How do you handle the travel, being away from your family? Many times, this guy's first time being away from their families that long. So it is a maturity process. But at the same time, there's only such a few. And if you're one of the few that have the skill set and you're ready to come to this level, we should welcome you with open arms.
The free throw dropped for Bazemore. And with this summer signing of Jimmy Butler, the Miami Heat demonstrating they still can lure star talent to South Beach.
The Heat back on the rise. The Butler signing sets the stage for the summer of 2021 when they should have the cap space to sign another max player.
Rashawn Holmes, he's checked in for Giles. And so Bazemore nails both of them. And here's Dragic. He'll bring it up for the Miami Heat. Last game matched up with the Clippers. A tough loss there.
Yeah, I mean, on the road, their defense was just overrun. Couldn't match the intensity of the opponent, and it cost them.
They looked overmatched, yeah. I thought they lacked aggressiveness and heart out there.
Now, here's Bazemore. Looking at his point production, he averages almost 8 points a game. Back to Bogdanovic. Five to shoot. Pass to Holmes. From deep three-point range. Rebound by Olynyk.
He missed that one, but I've seen him drill shots from that distance in warm-ups.
Yeah, and I have too, which is why they're okay with it. I'm sure if he gets that kind of look again, he's going to let it fly again. Well, I think he's looking around wondering where the D is. I mean, nowhere near him, that's for sure.
1:19 left in the first quarter. Bazemore against Crowder. Bazemore passes to Joseph. Here's Bogdanovich. And plenty of contact on the shot. So, two free throws coming up. And there's the call. Miami with the foul.
Well, an all-around threat with a promising future. I mean, Bogdanovich has the tools and the drive. He can be a solid player in this league for many years.
And he knocks down the first one.
Hey, Chris, there's a lot to like for this Kings franchise right now. Fans have got to be excited about their future.
Yeah, and credit my man Vlade in the front office for rebuilding. They got lots of great young talent, and they've kept their picks. The team should be a big factor in the West in the coming years.
Derrick Jones, he's checked in for Andre Iguodala. The Heat with the lead. Dragic looking for an opening, and he starts out with the miss in this one. Sacramento's gone 1-5 from downtown in the first quarter. Points out there have been hard to come by. Bazemore dishes to Joseph. Now here's Bazemore. He's guarded close. Count that one.
Oh, that's some fancy ball handling right there. Since when does he take guys off the dribble?
Here's Dragic. That's in, and he found his range with that one. Now one for two.
And a nice job here early of establishing an inside presence.
Pass to Bazemore. About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. Fires at the elbow. He can't get that one to fall. So at the end of one quarter of play, still a close game. Heat lead by one. Live from Golden 1 Center, you're watching 2K Sports. The trade deadline is approaching, and Jimmy Butler talked about how it feels hearing your name in trade rumors.
Rumors are different for everybody, to tell you the truth. For me, I don't think about it because whatever's going to happen is going to happen. You go out there and control what you can control. You know, try to help your team win games, play to the best of your abilities. And if it just so happens you get traded, then you got to suit up and play for the next team.
Staying level-headed and ready for whatever's next. That's Jimmy's mindset, Greg, in a nutshell.
And it's fair to say that the level of professionalism and maturity he possesses is really impressive.
And getting going again here in the second quarter. Fairly close game so far. And what stands out to you guys from the Heat in this one?
Well, this is the edge that great rim protection can give you.
Showing no mercy right now. The shooters look frustrated, seeing so many of their shots get stifled.
Rashawn Holmes out there with Bogdanovich. Then it's Corey Joseph. Then it's Alex Len. And it's Bazemore at the two. That's the five to begin the second quarter for the Kings. Now, here's Bogdanovich. A 23-point game for him in the win against Minnesota. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. Good shot selection, largely dependent on getting open. Which players do the best job of moving, you think, right now without the ball?
Period. Klay Thompson, 60 points, 11 dribbles. Did you hear me?
I got
60
it.
Points,
shocking.
11 dribbles.
It almost looks like a misprint, doesn't it?
Yeah, it is.
That free throw, no good. And he sinks the second. And it's Dragic bringing up the ball for the Heat. Over Joseph. No good off the back of the rim.
It isn't the D that causes that miss. That's just a loss of concentration that time.
And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, after years and years of rebuilding, the Kings are finally a team on the rise, and they're earning respect. Draymond Green said they've got a lot of young talent, never quit. Probably the fastest team in the history of the NBA. Green said after he plays them, I leave the game exhausted. I go home, I'm dead. And Kevin, we know that Green is pretty accustomed to going all out.
David, he sure is. He's got a lot of engine in him. Thank you so much. No good from Dragic.
The rotation in the D could be better here. It'll cost him next time if it's not.
Dragic against Joseph. Outside, Bogdanovich. And it's Bogdanovich again missing.
He's forcing things a little bit in this quarter, settling for shots that he'd be better off passing. No, they say there are no easy finishes in the NBA, but that should have been easy.
The 11-footer, almost, but it rolls out. The Heat have gotten only one of their first four shots in the second quarter to drop. His first shot coming late. Miami no good on that time either. Sacramento's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. And Joseph kicks to Holmes. And the pass to Bogdanovich. With the floater, and he sinks the layup. Bogdanovich has got the lead up to 2 now for Sacramento.
The IQ of Bogdanovich is impressive. It's clear he's comfortable operating in the pick and roll.
Hero passes to Crowder. He dishes it to Dragic. To stop the drought. Rebound by the Kings. Bogdanovich has got his 4th rebound in this one. Bazemore, no one around him. Hits it from 3-point range. Now it's a 5-point Kings lead.
Oh, he just caught the defense napping. He shoots a very high percentage from 3-point range, and there's no hand in his face.
And Miami calls their first timeout of the game.
Yeah, things not going their way, and he wants to just try to talk this one over.
Well, the defensive intensity has to pick up, and I'm sure coach is going to let them know that.
A platoon swap here for Sacramento. A different look for Miami.
And check out the numbers for Jimmy Butler. The last 10 games, he has been on a heck of a run. He's putting up about 20 points per game, 5 assists, and 6 rebounds. And he does so much for this team, but it starts with the way he leads the offense.
Yeah, he's willing to take on the scoring load, and he's more than capable of delivering.
Here's Robinson. It's blocked, and they force the shot clock violation. Great team.
Yeah, with no defensive pressure at all, you've got to be able to make that exchange.
And it's Sacramento's ball. It's been 8 unanswered points for him. Healed against Butler. Passes it to Barnes. No good from outside.
Having a hand up in your face makes such a difference to a shooter.
Yeah, that's a good defender making a great play, and he does it without fouling.
Well, that's a double whammy, guys.
That's right. A great defensive play, then the emphatic stuff.
Oh, yeah, bang, bang. An impressive sequence that has them fired up.
And it's Barnes slamming it down.
Oh, yeah, we've seen the evolution of Fox as a passer, and with every pass like that, it's obvious how far he's come.
The Heat trail by 9, and what just drops your jaw, Chris, with Fox is just how quick he gets up and down the floor.
Yeah, he's an absolute bullet once he gets out in transition. A good amount of his points come from just beating everyone else down the floor when he pushes the tempo.
Here's Heald, following the score by Miami. Lock at 6. And again, it's Sacramento converting.
And just a great second quarter for them after such a difficult first, bringing that field goal percentage up from below 30 and now with the lead.
Nunn passes to Robinson. Kicks it to Butler. Miami needs to get a shot off. Deep 2 from Robinson. That one wide left. Here's Sacramento. They're on a 14-2 run here. Heald with it. Butler covering. The feed to Leonard. Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a 3-point play chance for him.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
The Heat have gone 2 of 4 at the free throw line. And the Heat making a change here. Iguodala's checked in.
Find the lane. Find the lane. One shot.
Free throw drops for Leonard. Chris, if your team's style of play doesn't seem to be working, do you still have time within a season to change it?
There's always time. As long as everyone is on the same page, and if something's not working, the worst thing you can do is to keep going in that direction. You need to bring everyone in, let them know the mistakes that we've made, let them know our new outlook, and ask everyone, are they in on it? And if they're not, those guys that aren't in on it, we stay in the locker room, we'll be back after the game. And if everyone's in on it, we're going to have a heck of a time. We're going to have a heck of a time because now we have a new outlook, and sometimes with a new outlook, it brings positive energy.
Every team looking to get easy ones in transition.
Well, Greg, that's about as high percentage a look as you're going to get running the floor beautifully.
Here's Nunn. He's been a factor in their offense on most nights with his scoring average at nearly 16 points a game. Shots good by Butler.
Now, they've tailored their offense around him. And let me tell you, he loves playing in this system.
Fox against Iguodala. Giles, the pass to Heald, laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Heald's got his second basket of the night.
Their interior has been inferior defensively. It has got to tighten up.
Here's Butler. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Giles has got his seventh rebound here tonight. Here's Fox. And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for two. And Miami called for the foul.
Well, that's what you want to do. Fox forces the defender to commit, gets him in a tough spot, and gets a trip to the line.
The Kings have hit most of their free throws tonight, 5 of 6.
And I think this is a strength of this team. Solid numbers at the line across the board, 77% collectively.
And he makes the first.
And guys, I've heard that Fox honed a lot of his basketball skills by playing NBA 2K. What up, Fox? Well, check it out. He learned the art of the pick and roll off ball screens, and he says that he's just about unbeatable at that game, too. Hey, Fox, I got you, baby. We can play anytime you want to.
Second free throw, no good. And so it's Iguodala. He'll bring it up for the Miami Heat. 9-point game. Nunn passes to Butler. To the paint. Whoops, they pick off the pass. Heald outside. Leonard against Fox. Got a piece of it. 5 on the clock. He kicks it to Heald. Let's the 3 fly. Miami grabs the miss.
Well, if you can't hit that one, your teammates are going to think twice about feeding you the next time down.
Butler passes to Leonard. Over Heald. Leonard, no luck. Kings leading now by 9. Right side, Fox. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark.
He'll breathe a big sigh of relief if they hang on to win this game. He's not done much to contribute to it.
And it's blocked. Makes the shot. Basket number 4 this game. Brings him up to 4 for 9.
Oh, he's a crafty offensive talent. I mean, Fox can really make defenders pay around the rim.
Here's Nunn, covered by Heald. Nunn passes to Butler. Shoots over Fox. And it's Butler missing. Sacramento's gotten into trouble with the 3 ball in the second quarter, only hitting 1 of 5 attempts. Fox against Butler. Here's Heald. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
Hill is an excellent shooter. He's fantastic at going into contact. He likes getting to the line.
The Kings have shot 75% at the stripe, 6 of 8. Free throw drops for Heald.
Yeah, it's obvious that Hield is a talented player. Whether he takes that next leap to stardom, that's up to him.
Some changes for Sacramento. Rashawn Holmes comes in for Giles. And it's Kent Bazemore in for Bielitsa. No good on the second, so he hits 1 of 2. The Heat trail by 12. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
And here's Dragic. He's coming off a 13-point game against the Clippers in Los Angeles.
Yeah, but it wasn't all about himself. I mean, he kept everybody else in the loop. His passing was tremendous.
And so it's Sacramento, enjoying a 12-point lead as they talk things over during the break. They have made it very tough to get a shot off against them. Their defense has been stifling. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Harrison, a strong first half for you guys defensively. What has worked at that end?
We're trying to be active. You know, this is a very good team. They've been shooting the ball really well from three, so we're just trying to run them off the line.
So far, so good. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and the Jet, Kenny Smith. Let's get to it. A pretty close game for the Kings throughout the first quarter. They never trailed by more than 3 points, and it was neck and neck the entire period. The second quarter was all theirs. Major uptick in offensive and defensive intensity as they did their jobs with precision, now sitting on a comfortable 12-point lead at the half. Shaq, how did you think the Kings were playing?
Well, I like it, Ernie, because they're just not settling for outside shots. You know, that part of the game is pretty when it's going in. We've seen plenty of teams try that and fail. Got to have a balanced approach. And tonight, they found a ton of success inside. Basketball and championships are won inside out. Trust me, I know what I'm talking about.
Kenny, what'd you think about Miami?
Well, obviously, they were outshot. I thought they mailed it in too many times in terms of their effort. People weren't moving, they weren't screening, and they definitely weren't hustling. They need to hit the ground running to be competitive in the second half, or they could get blown out.
And that'll about do it as we get ready for the second half. Let's take you down to Kevin Harlan.
Shout out to my main man, Joel.
Joel, what up?
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Without question, De'Aaron Fox displaying his skills today.
No problems fighting his way to the rim in this one. A lot of points in close.
Yeah, slicing through the gaps in the defense. I mean, getting many of his buckets in the paint.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball. And for Miami, looking who they've got out there. They've got Jimmy Butler. Myers Leonard is out there with Bam Adebayo. Then it's Robinson, and it's Nunn in at the point guard position.
Still his go-to shot. Give Barnes any room to get comfortable from there, he's going to score.
And really, for a long time, the specter hanging over Buddy Hield was he's the player who was traded for DeMarcus Cousins. Hard billing to live up to, but he has made some giant leaps with his development.
Here's Giles. Up top, heel. And again, it's Sacramento converting.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
Starting to take over here, building a big lead that could ultimately prove insurmountable.
All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, Jimmy Butler has made several All-Star teams, but he remains single-minded in pursuit of his bigger goal. Butler said, "I just want to win a championship. That's all that matters. I didn't do it in high school, didn't do it in college. If I don't win it here, then I'll go to the 50 and over league someday. But I got to win a championship at some stage." Kevin?
I like that attitude. Thank you, D.A. And Heald has slowly but surely turned himself into one of the elite shooters in the NBA.
And guys, to be as locked in as he is from deep with his height and release is deadly. He's the kind of player who gets better as his teammates get better around him, and he is just now finding his stride.
Fox with the steal. A finish, and it's Fox with the jam.
I mean, it's almost a done deal when Fox comes up with the steal and has the open court in front of him. He's not stopping until he's finished the break himself.
And the Heat call time here. Chris, you've been a commentator for the NBA Vegas Summer League. Amazing how much that event has grown.
Oh, how about this year? The Chinese, the Croatian national team. I mean, come on. This is a global game, and we're bringing all of them to Vegas to let fans go up in there and watch them and watch rookies at a young, early age and see the best players. I mean, this is awesome. You got to love how forward-thinking the NBA is. This is really cool to watch.
It is.
And while we have a chance, how about the numbers for Fox? He's averaging 20 points, 7 assists, and 4 rebounds. To have a scorer like him consistently deliver you points makes such a big difference for a team.
Yeah. It gives you something you really can rely on going into every game. And you can also work off of him to look to create for others.
Now, here's Adebayo. Count that bucket.
An 0-for-3 start to the first half is finally behind them. I mean, now maybe they can get something rolling.
Fox with it. Robinson picks him up. Fox passes to Barnes.
The 7th overall pick in 2012 out of North Carolina. Harrison Barnes won a title in Golden State. Signs the big contract with Dallas, but yet to achieve the stardom that many predicted back in high school.
Shooting 2.
That one is off.
Well, at this stage of his career, Barnes knows who he is. He's a glue guy who does a bit of everything out there.
And some changes here for the Kings. Alex Lenz checked in for Giles, and it's Bogdanović in for Heal. And Miami with a change here, too. Olynyk checked in. He hits the 2nd from the line. The Heat trail by 21. Here's Nunn. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. It's going to go on De'Aaron Fox.
Clearly a foul.
Greg, you look at Harrison Barnes. What's his best role?
I mean, Kevin, he's a hard worker, able to hit the spot up 3. Defensively, his strength gives him some versatility, just a solid contributor.
First one falls for him. So he gets them both. Right around 3 minutes into the 2nd half. Outside, Fox. And there's the whistle. Illegal screen. And this, now a list of guys who can shoot it as well as they can pass it. The point guards with the highest shooting percentage in the NBA. 4th, De'Aaron Fox.
As a point guard, you want to create the best possible shot every trip down the floor. And given the way these guys have shot the ball, you know, it's not a bad idea every now and then for them to go it alone.
When you can shoot like they can, why not? I mean, the threat of their shooting make them more effective at the point.
6 to shoot. Here's Olynyk. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup. Olynyk got his second bucket.
A gifted scorer around the rim. Olynyk can finish over either shoulder, and he's got great touch.
Outside, Fox. Puts it up from 12. He gets it in there. Fox has got 13 points.
And what a fantastic start here to the second half. They have yet to miss.
Here's Nunn, guarded by Fox. Nunn can't get it to fall.
I'd love to see them impose themselves a little more on the backcourt. That's a great way to find confidence. Always a surefire way to get back in the game.
Now, here's Fox. He's got 13.
Fourth foul of the game for him. He's starting to get into that danger zone.
Sacramento making a switch here. Joseph's checked in. Heroes checked in for Miami. And Sacramento has possession. Their defense has only allowed 6 points in the second half. Six on the shot clock. Plenty of daylight on that shot. He's got 9.
And with their hot shooting here in the second half, their field goal percentage over 50% now for the game.
Here's Nunn. The kick outside to Butler. Over Bielica. Here's Olynyk, and the dunk by Olynyk.
Oh, I love that aggressiveness from Olynyk. I mean, he can create his own offense. I mean, we all know that, but that time with a little cleanup work.
Now, here's Joseph. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Here's Barnes. Rebound by Olynyk.
For a player who's almost a sure thing to score in tight, that was a stunner.
Here's Nunn. Pass to Hero. Dishes to Butler. Over Barnes. Good D by Barnes.
And you know what? He's just not on his game. No doubt about it. Their deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not been an asset for his team.
Shot by Joseph. No good. And so it's Butler with it. He'll bring it up for Miami. Trailing by 19. They get to take on the Blazers of Portland after this one. And that will be the third of the six-game road trip.
And this is the level of unselfishness that Butler brings. A total pro who moves the ball well.
Here's the lob to the hoop. Stolen by Robinson. Pass to Butler. Here's Nunn. He's covered by Joseph. And the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
The Heat have gone 5 of 7 from the free throw line in the game. Rashawn Holmes, he's checked in for the Kings. Ken Bazemore comes in for Joseph. And a new group in for the Heat. Jones checked in for Olynyk. Jay Crowder comes in for Robinson. Andre Iguodala is checked in for Butler. And it's Dragic in for Hero. Sacramento leading by 13. Now here's Bazemore. He has 7. Outside, Bogdanović. Sacramento again missing. Dragic with it. Now guarded by Bogdanović. And the shot is good. And that's now 6 points for Goran Dragic.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
Now here's Bazemore. The pass to Len. Knocked loose. It's stolen by Jones. And now Jones running the floor all by himself.
And looking now at some numbers for Bogdanović. How his last 10 games have gone. Averaging 15 points a game, 3 rebounds, and 2 assists. To have a scorer like him consistently deliver you points makes such a big difference for a team.
Yeah. It gives you something you really can rely on going into every game. And you can also work off of him to look to create for others.
And the first one drops.
This is as good as it gets from the charity stripe here in the second.
De'Aaron Fox has checked in for Len. And Miami with a change here, too. Adebayo's checked in. And so Jones nails both of them. And here are the Kings now. Right side, Fox. And the turnover again by Sacramento. Now the Heat with it. They're on an 18-5 run. Dragic finds Adebayo. Crowder with it. Bazemore grabs the miss. Fox looking it over. Passes it to Bogdanovich. Iguodala with the steal. To the middle. Here's Dragic. He can't get it to go. Good work defensively by Fox. And with Andre Iguodala, he doesn't give you 20 points tonight like he once did, Greg, but he still shows up when you need him.
Iggy can still hit the switch, so to speak, and go back to his all-star level of play for stretches. I mean, the numbers don't jump out at you, but he is so valuable during big games, particularly in the postseason.
And here are the Heat now. Sacramento able to drain the three. Shot clock at 5. Here's Dragic. Bogdanovich grabs the miss. Bogdanovich has got 5 rebounds tonight. Pass to Bazemore. Dragic against Bogdanovich. With the shot, cans the shot from the wing. Bogdanovich has got 14 points for the game.
A terrific, versatile scorer. I mean, once Bogdanovich gets hot, he stays assertive and on the attack.
A moment now to see the numbers for Holmes. Second in field goal percentage, 16th in blocks. And don't forget, top 20 in the league in rebounds per game. He's got a great nose for the ball.
And you mentioned it, he's the second best shooter in the league right now. Quick trigger with just a little bit better footwork. He could take over that top spot. And that one falls for Jones. Some changes for Sacramento. Giles comes in for Barnes. And it's Buddy Hield in for Bogdan Bogdanovich. And so Jones nails both of them. And here's Fox. He'll bring it up for the Kings. Leading by 12. Bazemore against Iguodala. On the wing, Hield. Four on the clock. That shot off. The Heat trail by 12. Iguodala wide open. And they cash in right away with the quick shot.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
Fox kicks to Hield. Pass to Bazemore. Kings moving the ball around. There's 18 seconds left in the third. Shoots the three. And another three for Sacramento.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
We see this all too often. You have to be willing to put in the work. And still showing primetime explosiveness at the rim. Nice catch and drop by Iguodala.
Hield from outside.
Oh, and he got it.
No way. What Woo. Focus from him right there. Nice play.
Yeah. They will go into the fourth quarter riding high. That's almost got to feel like a game winner to them.
And so it's the Sacramento Kings, sitting with a comfortable lead up by 14. Their transition game has been in full effect. We'll return shortly. And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
And just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
How about the unselfishness? Night in and night out, we see guys trying to force their own agenda. Not that time.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. Fox at the point with Heel to his side. They're the backcourt. Rashawn Holmes out there with Kent Bazemore, and it's Giles in at the center, locking down the middle. So that's the five in the game for Sacramento.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Heeled outside. The pass to Fox. And again, it's Sacramento converting.
The defense can't do anything about that. I mean, sometimes Fox just beats you with better offense.
Pass to Adebayo. Lobs it up for Crowder. Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop. Here's Fox. That counts. He's put up 13 shots, and he's had 8 of those go in.
This system is set up perfectly for him today. I mean, it's allowing him to find a lot of good shots.
Here's Dragic. An easy 2 points on the layup.
I mean, he makes plays like that in his sleep. The game is just far too easy.
Outside, Fox. Shot from 12. That one doesn't drop. Now the Heat take it the other way. Crowder dishes to Iguodala. Outside, Dragic. The three, and it's Fox with the rebound. Fox has got 4 rebounds in this game. Pass to Giles. The dish to Bazemore. Shot clock at 6. And here's the upcoming schedule now for the Miami Heat. On Sunday, they'll go up against C.J. McCollum and the Portland Trail Blazers. Then on Monday, they'll take on Steph Curry and the Golden State Warriors.
And just looking ahead to what's on tap, there are a lot of winnable games for them, but you can't go into the stretch with that mentality. You've got to focus on what's in front of you and bring it every night.
He misses the free throw. Bialica, he's checked in for the Kings. And then for Miami, Myers Leonard, he's checked in for Crowder. Robinson comes in for Derrick Jones, and it's Butler in for Andre Iguodala. And he's good on the second. The Heat trail by 15. Dragic kicks to Butler. Sacramento grabs the miss. Bialica's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Over to the wing. Giles, the pass to Heel. That's his 6th field goal today, and that makes him now 6 for 11.
He's made the most of the halftime break. He shook off the problems he had in the first half, and he started to settle in.
Bialica against Dragic. It's deflected.
And they've only got a slight edge on the boards, but it just feels a lot bigger.
Down low. Fox against Butler. Pass to Giles. Stolen by Robinson. Butler in the corner. And the 3 off target.
His effort level is there. You can't blame him on that. He's working to get good shots. It's just not connected.
Fox, no good.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender.
Yeah, you can see why he's established that reputation. Strong understanding of how to defend at the rim.
Kings leading now by 17. To the inside. And the dunk by Bialica.
And look, I like whenever Bialica finishes with force. With the right positioning, he's a problem.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Butler feeling it out a bit. The putback. It's good on the putback.
And those second chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
Dragic against Fox. The 11-footer. Empty that time from Leonard. And it's Dragic bringing up the ball for the Miami Heat. 17-point game. And Adebayo throws it down. That gives him the double-double. 10 points and 10 rebounds.
And hard to decide which was better, the pass, the catch, or the slam.
Well, there's no wrong answer. Sensational alley-oop. And Miami has possession. Sacramento making their last shot. Now Butler. Let's a floater go, and that's 2 points on the layup.
He's so focused. Butler does not let the defender get into his head. That's a sign of an elite score.
Fox passes to Giles. At the top of the key, Heel. Shakes off the strong D and gets to the bucket for two.
With the second half he's having, I mean, his field goal percentage is way up there.
Outside Butler. And De'Aaron Fox gets the whistle that time. That's foul number two for him. The Kings making a switch here. Barnes is checked in, and Miami also making a switch. Nunn's checked in. Here's Adebayo, and it's Bjelica with the foul. That's his fourth foul of the contest. Robinson against Barnes. Robinson, that's good. Kings leading now by 15. The pass to Heel. Five to shoot. Knocked away. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. Here's Nunn.
Come to me, come to me.
Butler with the ball. Inside. Adebayo. And that one barely misses as he draws contact. Two free throws coming up. And bam, Adebayo. He just plays with so much energy when he's on the floor.
Boy, he is ferocious on both ends of the floor. Great energy player who can finish in the paint with the best of them. Very quick on his feet and can cover a lot of ground for a player his size.
Free throw good, Adebayo. And so he makes both from the line. Two-time NBA champion Michael Thompson says the arm muscles, Chris, on today's players don't measure up with what they used to be. Is that even important?
You know what? He's right, but I don't know how important that is unless, you know, you just want to bring the gun show to the games and then pull out the arms and the curls and say, check out these muscles. But now I think, you know, it's a lot different. And make no mistake, even though that is a true comment, the players of today are much more athletic than his day and my day. And I think that's because of technology. They understand core strength. They understand dieting. They understand rest. They're privy to so much information that we didn't have. But, yeah, no more curls. It doesn't seem like there are any more Karl Malone 24-inch pythons, brother, out there in any of these games.
Here's Nunn after the basket by De'Aaron Fox. And again, it's the Heat missing. Heeled against Butler, and that's a foul called on Bam Adebayo. That is his first foul of the game. Here's Giles. Down low. It's stolen by Adebayo.
I don't like that decision there on the entry pass. Not with the defender right there ready to pick it off.
Wow, an explosive athlete that can beat you inside and outside. Butler's a complete player.
Now, here's Fox. It's hauled in by the Heat. Adebayo's got the glass covered here tonight. 11 boards for him. Here's Nunn, covered by Heal. Nunn passes to Butler. Six to shoot. Feeds it to Robinson. Fox with the steal. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Such a tricky cover inside. When Fox attacks like this, the defense responds with that same type of aggression.
Shooting two.
That free throw missing. Good on the second free throw. The Heat trail by 14. And here is Butler. Poke loose. Adebayo passes to Butler. Just five to shoot. From outside the arc, hands it from downtown.
I love Butler's composure in pressure situations. He doesn't really get rattled.
Now here's Barnes. Passes it to Giles. Heald kicks to Bialica. The three from Barnes. Rebound by the Heat. Here's Nunn. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. Butler's got his fifth assist in this one. Sacramento leading by nine. Outside, Fox. Giants. And a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
Oh, the movement off the ball is good. I mean, and the pass to hit him in stride is even better.
Well, they're passing to Adebayo. And Adebayo throws it down.
And in terms of size, not your typical center, but man, he plays as big as any of them thanks to that terrific leaping ability. And we'll just watch the clock wind down, guys, in what will turn out to be a win here for Sacramento.
The biggest factor tonight had to be their great shooting. They shot much better than the other two.
Yeah, they were working hard on both sides of the floor, but that sky-high field goal percentage plus the pressure defense to force the other team into a lot of misses. Love the effort tonight.
And a milestone win for the season. This will push their victory total to 20 wins even.
Important. With this win, they split the season series at a game apiece and also avoid the sweep. And that has to be a relief.
And a lot of players tonight helped contribute to this performance. But in particular, a real good game it was for De'Aaron Fox.
He had a nose for the basketball tonight, playing some disruptive D and picking pockets left and right.
Well, this one is winding down now. Sacramento can run out the clock. Butler against Heald. So it's Sacramento picking up the win. A confident win and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
Yeah, I mean, it was a solid performance, particularly here at home. I think they built off that edge of being here and playing with just a little more confidence than their opponent.
And that'll do it, folks. For Chris Webber, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. So long.